हेलो एवरीवन, वन सेकेंड, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल मैरान आर्शियान। सो माय चैनल इज़ ऑल ओवर मर्चेंट नेवी, मैरान इंजीनियरिंग, नॉटिकल साइंस, इंजन डिपार्टमेंट एंड डेक डिपार्टमेंट।
हे या गाइस, गुड टू सी यू ऑल वंस अगेन। टुडे वी आर गोना डिस्कस अबाउट पंप कैरेक्टरिस्टिक कर्व। गाइस, व्हाट इज पंप कैरेक्टरिस्टिक कर्व? बेसिकली इट क्लियरली एक्सप्लेन्स अबाउट द बेसिक बिहेवियर एंड बेसिक परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ द पंप अंडर डिफरेंट कंडीशन। So guys, this pump characteristic curve is explained by different parameter like flow rate, head pressure, pump efficiency and horsepower. So guys, these are the few parameters which we are gonna use it and explain the pump characteristic curve in an easy and effective way. So guys, this is actually how the pump characteristic curve look like. Guys, don't you feel this particular pump characteristic curve is little complicated, as all the characteristics are compacted in one particular graph? As this particular graph look really messy and really complicated, we are gonna break this particular graph into three segments, that is flow rate or capacity versus head, and flow rate or capacity versus pump efficiency, and flow rate or capacity versus horsepower. This particular flow rate or capacity is common for all of them, and it is included in the x-axis, while the other parameter like head, pump efficiency and horsepower are included in the y-axis. So guys, let's go to the video and have a clear understanding of the pump characteristic curve. So this is how we are gonna deal the pump characteristic curve: flow rate versus pressure head, flow rate versus pump efficiency, flow rate versus horsepower. And later, as the video unfolds, we are gonna tackle this particular pump characteristic curve in this way, that is flow rate in the x-axis versus in the y-axis pressure head, pump efficiency and horsepower. So guys, don't worry about this. Today we are gonna make this particular funda very clear. I am gonna explain this particular funda in terms of practical examples. So guys, stay with me till the end of this video. I assure you guys, this video will really blow your mind and it will be really helpful for you guys. So guys, no matter whatever exam you are gonna attempt, no matter which interview you are gonna attempt, all your fundas, all your ideas will be clear. So guys, let's move on to the pump characteristic curve and have a detailed view and detailed understanding of this particular curve. So guys, first of all, we are going to study about flow rate versus pressure head. So the first module is flow rate versus pressure head curve. So guys, flow rate is in the x-axis represented by Q and having a unit meter cube per hour, and pressure head is in the y-axis represented by H and having a unit of meter or feet. So guys, consider a centrifugal pump and the centrifugal pump is running having discharge valve closed. As the discharge valve is closed, it will be having a huge pressure inside building up. So the pressure head at that particular time will be maximum as the discharge valve is closed. So that will be around this particular point, that is shut off point. So from this particular point, as you open the discharge valve, as the flow rate increases, the pressure head is going to drop in this fashion. Oh man, this seems very boring. So let's understand this particular phenomena in a practical way. What do you say guys? So you can see very clearly, as I have closed the discharge port, the pressure head is increased drastically, the flow rate is reduced, and once I open, it is vice versa. So let's consider another example, that you really want to pee and you are not finding any toilet nearby you, and the pressure inside your bladder, that is urinary bladder, will be very high. So this will be the pressure at that particular moment, that is the shutoff pressure. Your pressure inside your bladder will be very high, and once you find a toilet, you will be very eager to pass the urine. So as you pass the urine, the flow rate will increase. So as the flow rate increase, the pressure head or the pressure inside your bladder will be reduced. So you can see this particular graph. Once you start peeing, the pressure inside will drop as the flow rate increases. So this is this particular graph which clearly explains the practical example as well as our theoretical concept. So I hope this particular example was really helpful for you understanding the head versus flow rate concept. So guys, let's move on to our second module, that is flow rate versus pump efficiency. So you can see very clearly in the x-axis it is flow rate represented by Q and of unit meter cube per hour, and in the y-axis it is pump efficiency represented by eta and having a unit of percentage. So you can clearly see the trend of the graph, that is, as the flow rate in the x-axis increases, the pump efficiency is also going to increase, and upon reaching a particular point known as peak efficiency point, the efficiency is going to drop as the flow rate increases. Every machine will have their peak efficiency. So in our case, our pump will have peak efficiency at certain flow rate. So at this flow rate, our peak efficiency will be reached. Beyond this flow rate, our efficiency will drop. Our bike will perform the best once we ride our bike in the economy speed. So once we ride the bike in our economy speed, we will be having the best mileage. So obviously the efficiency of the bike is going to increase. You might have seen the economy zone marked on the speedometer. So it is always recommended to ride the bike in the economy zone so as to have the best mileage. Let's move on to our third module, that is flow rate versus horsepower. So you can see the flow rate versus horsepower graph. The flow rate is shown in the x-axis while the horsepower is shown in the y-axis. So guys, you can understand from the graph that as the flow rate increases in the x-axis, the power consumption by the motor increases in the y-axis. Motor is the one which drives the pump through shaft. So you can see as the flow rate increases, the power is going on increasing. It is normal practice on board a ship to shut off the discharge valve of the centrifugal pump when the pump is started. During the starting time, the initial torque generated by the pump will be very high. As the initial torque is very high, obviously the starting current is going to shoot up. So as to reduce the starting current, we are closing the discharge valve. As the discharge valve is closed, obviously there will be no load on the motor. As there is no load on the motor, obviously we can save the motor from tripping off. Let's consider the example of the fan. As the speed of the fan is being increased from 1 to 2 and 2 to 3, obviously the speed of the fan is going to increase and the power consumption too. So guys, let's move on to our fourth module, that is combining all the four characteristics. So on the x-axis it will be flow rate versus on the y-axis it will be pressure head, pump efficiency and horsepower. So guys, this is how actually the pump efficiency curve look like. So I hope this pump efficiency curve is much more easier and clearer than it was few minutes ago. So you can see the head versus flow rate curve, it keeps on reducing as we have learned earlier. Now guys, why it keeps on reducing is because of some frictions and some eddies in this way. So because of friction and eddies, it keeps on reducing, and other all details I have explained earlier. So this is the pump efficiency curve which you can see on the graph. So the efficiency will be keeping on increasing as the flow rate increases. So upon reaching a particular point, that is the peak efficient point, from that point onwards, as the flow rate increases, the efficiency will keeping on dropping. So this particular point is known as peak efficiency point, as we have discussed earlier. So you can see at the head curve also, as the flow rate increases, the head, that is the pressure head, will reduce. So the point of meeting of the pressure head and the peak efficient point is known as best efficiency point, that is BEP. So you can also see the horsepower over here. The power consumption by the motor keeps on increasing as the flow rate increases. So basically, in this particular graph, we have combined all the three characteristics, that is pressure head, pump efficiency, and obviously the horsepower. So guys, we have discussed all the four modules as we have told earlier before the start of this video. I hope this video was really helpful for you guys. If you find this video really helpful, share with your friends. And if you find my channel is really helpful for you guys, subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for future notification. Thank you and have a nice day.